My name is Vasumati.
To me, the Cochrane collaboration gave me the opportunity to be the statistician without borders. It has been really motivating for all of us to work together, exchange ideas, meet once per year. And I think that has been a major force that leads forward to new methods developments.
In terms of the science, the organization has brought together some of the best minds around the methods. And these groups are prepared to share and work together in developing methods. So that is in part why the organization and the methods have moved so quickly.
There's a gold standard has been established, and that is very much around the rigor of the methodological structure of the Cochrane Review, the transparency of it, the way it's conducted and put together, and also how it's published on the Cochrane Library, that it's very explicit and methodologically you can follow it step by step, which is not necessarily always the case in all published systematic reviews.
Right from the start, in Cochrane, the idea is you have to write a protocol. You have to say what your plans are, what your intention is. That, of course, is good research practice for any research, but it's particularly important, I think, here. We came up with a more sophisticated system of assessing the risk of bias, and indeed moved away from using the word quality, which is a very value-laden term which I always try to avoid in most circumstances. There's a transparency to it. So rather than simply somebody saying, we think this study is good or poor or what have you, there are six questions they have to answer, and they have to explain within the review. They have to explain what is the rationale for their judgment on each of those. And if there's a particular piece of text in a publication that leads them to a particular conclusion, that will be lifted into the review. So it's transparent to the reader what is the basis for their judgment that this study is a high risk of bias.
For 20 years, the Cochrane Collaboration has pursued rigorous methodology to achieve the best possible evidence. Now, the collaboration seeks to improve the application of evidence through summary of findings tables based on the grading of recommendations assessment, development and evaluation, or GRADE.
Porque las revisiones sistemáticas son un documento precioso en el sentido de que usted puede ver todo lo que pasó, pero no es útil para el clínico en el momento de tomar decisiones. Yo quiero tomar una decisión. ¿Y cómo hago para tomar una decisión con una revisión sistemática que me la tengo que leer toda? Las tablas de GRADE van a solucionar ese problema de accesibilidad a la información rápida.
The adoption by the Cochrane Collaboration of the GRADE approach and the use of summary of findings tables, that is the final output of the GRADE approach, has been fantastic.
From the perspective of someone who uses GRADE rather than the one who's developed it, we find it extremely useful when talking to policymakers and to clinicians. And what GRADE does is to only take the Cochrane evidence as one small piece of it to inform the final decision. So we're not trying to drive the decision. All we're saying is, please take into account the quality of the evidence.
We currently have 16 methods groups, and it's a broad range from groups that from there from the beginning, like a statistics and meta-analysis methods group or a bias assessment methods group, but we also have a qualitative research methods groups, applicability and recommendations methods groups. We have a new group called agenda setting and priority setting groups.
This has been a new challenge for review groups to actually understand and learn the new methodology for these reviews. They're methodologically more challenging. There's more ways in which you can evaluate a diagnostic test badly than you can evaluate an intervention study badly. It's not as simple as just a two-arm randomized controlled trial. So there's all sorts of different biases people have to be aware of. And one of the key issues is the actual way in which we summarize information about a diagnostic test. that we actually talk about two different numbers. We talk about how good it is at picking up people who have the disease, what's called the sensitivity of the test, and also how good it is at not wrongly diagnosing the disease in people who don't have that disease or have other diseases, which is the specificity of the test. And the fact that there are two numbers we have to understand makes the statistical analysis more complicated. In intervention studies, we just look at one number, the relative risk or the odds ratio.
So there's a whole load of new methods that are being developed all the time. I think that's what attracts the methodologists to Cochrane. We love that flow of new stuff coming through and having to implement it in our reviews.
Currently, there's quite an interest within the organisation into how we broaden, if you like, our standard model, our standard approach methodologically, which currently is using randomised controlled trials.
In my role as co-editor of the Cochrane Handbook, we have some responsibility for the sort of methods that we advocate people use. And at the moment, there are a lot of discussions about use of qualitative research. There are clearly places where it's invaluable in forming the review question. It's a necessary part of understanding why we get particular results, why interventions may or may not work.
We were quite on the outside of the peripheries to start with, because the original Cochrane concept was the randomised controlled trial, evidence of effectiveness. But there's lots more evidence around there about, you know, one classic example is, why do women who are pregnant choose more high-risk interventions like a caesarean section when they don't need it? Well, evidence of effectiveness doesn't mean anything to them, so we have to try and explain why they might choose to be put themselves or their baby more at risk, because it's a personal choice.
The experience of reviewers doing 4,500 reviews that are being looked at by some of the world's best methodologists has really helped us advance the science of systematic reviews.
We've got quite a sea change in Cochrane now. If we were looking to the future rather than the past, things like understanding complex interventions and all the types of evidence that you would need to understand complex interventions, that's all been accepted as now part of Cochrane.
Et ce qui est aussi très intéressant, c'est que ces méthodes évoluent sans cesse et que chaque année, il y a de nouvelles innovations méthodologiques et c'est ça aussi ce qui est l'esprit de la Cochrane, c'est de ne pas s'arrêter à un niveau méthodologique donné, mais en permanence d'évoluer dans ce domaine.